What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about configuring your Kiwi System Log server to retrieve Windows event logs. So let's get right into it. All right, so the last video we left off here with the system log from Kiwi up and running, and I want to start capturing the event logs on my database server. Now, to do this, we need to go into the SolarWinds downloads webpage. And on your left-hand side, we are going to click on product types and then enabled free tools. And on your right-hand side, we're going to go all the way to the bottom and locate event log forwarder for Windows. So we are going to click on the download free tool, and it's going to want you to enter information. So enter the information and then click on proceed to free download. And it's going to give you this. And you could click continue without adding this particular add-on, and it's going to take you here. So we are going to click on download now. Once it's downloaded, I'm going to click on the arrow and I'm going to pick on show in folder. It's going to open up my downloads folder. Now, for this particular file, it is zipped. So I'm going to right click on it and then click on 7-zip and then pick extract files. I'm going to click OK. And we're good. So I'm going to double click on the folder, and it comes with an exe file as well as an msi file that allows you to push it out, you know, silently and all that stuff. Now, with these two files, I'm going to copy and paste them inside the C drive under a folder that I created called install. Now, this install folder, I'm actually going to right click on it and go to properties. I'm going to go to sharing. I'm going to click on advanced sharing. And I'm going to enable share this folder. I'm going to click on apply, okay, and then close it. Now, the reason why I shared out that folder is because I'm going to have multiple Windows servers that I am going to install this particular plugin, because I want their Windows event logs to go into my system log server. Now, within my database server, I'm going to minimize my Management Studio. I am going to right click on the start menu, click on run. I'm going to type in the UNC path of that install file. So basically, you know, the network path of my, where the installation stuff is at. So click OK. It's going to load up. I'm going to highlight the exe one, which is the first one. I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to run it as an administrator and just follow the prompts. So next here, accept the license and terms. Next. I'm going to leave everything as the default. Click next here. I'm going to leave the default installation folder as is. Click next, install, and you're finished. You're going to get a shortcut on the desktop. So double click on that and it's going to load this up. Now, there's a couple of things that we need to configure on this console. We need to configure our subscription as well as our system log server. So we are going to go inside the system log server first, and we're going to click on add. And within add, we are going to give our server name and our server IP address. So this is all the information that I provided. And then you're going to click on create. So click on it. Now go back inside the subscription. And within the subscription, we are going to click on add. From here, you want to choose what type of events you want to kind of forward to your system log server. So pick whatever you want. These are the three that I picked. Once you pick what type of events you want to do, you're going to click on next. Within here, we're going to click on the drop down menu, and the one that I picked was logs alert. So we're going to click on finish. And once you click on finish, you're good to go. If you want to test it out, you can click on the test tab, and then you're able to just click on the drop down menu, pick an option. For me, I pick applications, and what type of test event you want to do. I did information. And I clicked on create a test event, and it went out successfully. Now, the way that you know it went out successfully is if you go back inside your system log server, you're going to see a new entry. Now, behind the scenes, I actually added a bunch of servers. One of the servers that I added was my Active Directory, my domain controller. And then that started picking up a lot of stuff. When I was logging into a lot of my servers, it was picking up all that information, which was great. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.